In this video, we're going to do an example involving counting the number of spanning trees in a given graph. So you can see to the left here, we have the graph in question. It's connected, and we want to know how many spanning trees there are. And we want to try to answer this without just listing every possible spanning tree. The reason is, first of all, in some examples, this could be very large, even though in this case it won't be. So we want to have an idea of how many possibilities there are. So before we do that, let's actually look at a similar example. Suppose I have a graph, 5 vertices, and I draw in edges in the following manner. And I ask the same question, how many spanning trees are there? Well, this is not a complete graph, so we don't have an easy formula to tell us the number of spanning trees. So we could say, well, there are 5 vertices. How many edges do we have? Well, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 edges. Now, if I want a spanning tree on these 5 vertices, that tree would have 5 vertices, so how many edges would it have to have? Well, remember, if a tree has n vertices, it must have n minus 1 edges. So if we want a tree with 5 vertices, we would need 4 edges. So one way that you can think of getting a spanning tree on these 5 vertices is to delete 2 edges. We have 6 edges, we actually only want 4. So among these 6 edges, we can choose to delete 2. But we can't do this in just any way that we want. We have to delete the edges in such a way that the edges that remain form a tree, right? A connected graph on the 5 vertices. So how could we do that? Why isn't this a tree already? Well, it's a connected graph, but it has circuits, right? A tree is a connected graph with no circuits. So a way to make it a tree then is that wherever we see a circuit, try to remove an edge so that we destroy the circuit. And so if we look, we can see that basically there are two fundamental circuits in this graph. There's that circuit that I've circled in the red, and there's another circuit now that I've circled in the blue. If we simply choose one edge to delete from the red circuit and choose another edge to delete from the blue circuit, we will have deleted two edges, we will still have a connected graph, and that will be a spanning tree. So in order to determine the number of spanning trees this graph has, it's the same thing as asking how many different ways we can delete two circuits in such a way that the remaining edges form a tree. But this is the same asking how many ways can we delete an edge from the red circuit and delete an edge from the blue circuit. Well, how many ways can we delete an edge from the red circuit? There are 3 edges that we could choose to delete, so there's 3 possibilities. And for the blue circuit, again, there's 3 edges. We could delete any one of them, so there's 3 possibilities there. And now, how many total ways combined? Well, notice that no matter which edge you choose to delete from the red circuit, it doesn't have any effect on the blue circuit. Suppose we chose to delete, say, this edge right here. Then it doesn't make any difference which edge we would delete from the blue circuit. We haven't restricted our option. Which edge we delete from the red circuit is independent of whichever edge we delete from the blue circuit. And so we satisfy the fundamental principle of counting, right? We have 2 counting tasks. How many ways can we delete an edge from the red circuit? And a second counting task is how many ways we can delete an edge from the blue circuit. The fundamental principle of counting says as long as those 2 tasks are independent, then the total number of ways for doing both is obtained by simply multiplying the numbers together. So in this case, because we have independence, we can multiply 3 and 3 together to get 9. So this will tell us there's 9 ways of deleting an edge from the red circuit and deleting an edge from the blue circuit, so therefore there are 9 different spanning trees. So we want to use the same type of reasoning and see if we can use it to solve the problem of how many spanning trees that this graph possesses. So we start out in the same way. How many vertices does our given graph possess? It has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 vertices. How many edges does it have? Well, it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 edges. Now, if we want a spanning tree on those 6 vertices, we want a tree with 6 vertices. How many edges do we need? Well, we want 5 edges. So again, we see we're in a very similar circumstance. We want to delete 2 edges among this given graph. Why isn't our graph a tree already? Well, because it has some circuits. So we want to delete edges in such a way that we destroy circuits and keep the graph connected. And so you can see that it looks very similar to our previous example. Here's one circuit that I've circled in red, and here's basically the other circuit that I've circled in blue. And you can kind of think, well, what I need to do is choose an edge from that red circuit and delete it, and choose an edge from the blue circuit and delete it. But now there's an important difference that this graph has from the previous example, which is that the two circuits before, recall that they looked like this, they didn't have any edges in common. But here, if we look at the red and blue circuit now, we can see that they share an edge. And that means they are no longer independent. The choice you make of the red circuit and the choice that you make of the edge in the blue circuit to delete are linked together because of that shared edge. How can we get past that? Let's just look at the red circuit for the moment. How many edges do I get to choose from? I want to delete one of those edges. Well, there's three of them, so I have three choices. And now, what about the blue circuit? Well, again, if I just consider the blue circuit and forget about the red one for a moment, there's three edges, so three choices. So the problem is I can't just quite multiply here. What choices are no longer an option? Well, basically the problem is, what if I had chosen this middle edge here? When I was choosing an edge to delete from the red circuit, what if I had chosen that green edge? Okay, now I have to delete an edge from the blue circuit. It means I can't choose that green edge again, because I've already deleted it from the red circuit, and so it's not an option anymore for the blue circuit. But every other option is still a possibility. So before, in the previous example, I had 9 choices. Now, we no longer have 9 choices because we've lost a possibility. Because of that shared edge, I've lost exactly one possibility. So in fact, we only have 8 spanning trees. Now, let's actually verify that. Let's kind of list the different possibilities. So let's call this A, B, let's call that middle edge C, D, and E. So what are my choices? Well, I have to choose an edge from the first circuit, and I have to choose an edge from the second circuit. So suppose I could choose A from the first circuit. So again, let me help kind of see things. Let me outline that circuit in red. Let me outline the other circuit in blue. So I could choose A from the red circuit. Now, what choices do I have from the blue circuit? Well, I could choose D. Now again, suppose again I choose A from the red circuit. I could choose E from the blue circuit. Now again, suppose I choose A from the red circuit. I could choose C, right? That is a viable possibility. I could delete A from the red circuit and think of deleting C from the blue circuit. Okay, those are the possibilities in which I start with A. Now, what if I start with B in the red circuit? Well, now I could choose to delete D. Again, if I start with B, I could get rid of E in the blue circuit. If I get rid of B in the red circuit, then I could get rid of C in the blue circuit. Again, that's perfectly fine. I'll have destroyed the two circuits, and the remaining graph will still be connected. In the red circuit, I choose C to start. Well, I could then delete D. Again, I could start with C and delete E. And here's the difference. If I delete C from the red circuit, I can't also delete it from the blue circuit because it's already gone. So that's the option that is now missing because the two circuits share an edge. So I cannot write down CC. That won't make any sense. So you can see that I still have 8 options. So if that edge C were in fact 2 different edges, if my circuits did not share an edge, I would have 9 options, but because they share an edge, I only have 8 options. And so there are 8 spanning trees.